What? Were you expecting something grand? Were you expecting some music? Maybe disco lights over here?
Neon lights.
Okay. Well, I'm sorry to disappoint you, but I thought, why not appear like Undertaker? While I was writing my P6, I thought, that show always does something innovative, then why shouldn't I? And as you know, in TMND, doing something innovative means switching the lights off and playing music. And for those of you who are new to the club or are attending the meeting for the first time, Toastmaster Shay, whenever he's asked to do something innovative, he quickly closes the light, installs the disco light, and puts some music in. That's what I've learned from my very good friend and the president of our club, Shay Saxena. Good evening, Toastmasters and dear guests.
Good evening!
John Rim once quoted that you are the average of the five people you spend your most time with. In layman terms, this quote means that the five people who you spend the most time with decide who you are. They shape who you are. So, have you ever noticed that when you're spending a lot of time with someone, you start picking up their habits. You start copying their actions. You start turning off the lights. Well, that is what I've learned from Shay again. And we may meet a lot of people in our day-to-day lives, but the people whom we spend our most time with actually decide how we take our future decisions and actually decide where our life is actually headed. My mother always used to be very careful about the company I'm keeping, and this day, standing over here, I know why she used to do that. Mm-hmm. Let me take you to a very interesting incident that happened in Sydney in the early 1980s. I hope everyone has heard of Sydney. It's a city in Australia. And well, Sydney was a pelican's paradise back then. Now, for those of you who don't know, pelicans are birds with really long beaks. They live near the coastal areas and generally hunt fishes for their food.
Nemo.
Yeah, exactly. Nemo. So, well, these birds, it was a paradise. Sydney was a paradise for them because there were tons of fish factories along the coast of Sydney. And what these fish factories did was when the fishermen used to come back with their catch, they used to scrape off the fishes and all the leftovers went to the pelicans. The pelicans feasted on those leftovers. Without having to break a sweat, they were able to have a lavish lunch, breakfast and dinner. Without even to flap a wing, they had all the food in the world for them. But well, for most of you were thinking, oh, that's great, no food for me. Food for me without any effort sounds great. But well, there was danger looming in this thought. One by one, all the fish factories started to close because the Sydney coastline had been abused beyond repair. All the fishes had vanished, and so with that, all the factories shut down. And with that, the pelicans started to starve and die. And why they started to starve and die was because naturally, pelicans are great fish hunters. In groups, they roam above the sea, and whenever they see some fish on the surface, they dive down and catch that fish with their beak and go and have their merry lunch. Now, while they were doing that, but they won't have any option now because the fishes were because the scrapes were exhausted and they weren't getting any food. And that sent the preservationists of the area into a tizzy. All the pelicans were starving and dying because of this very fact. There was a danger that Sydney won't see any pelicans if no step was taken immediately back then. And well, there was an ingenious idea that one of the preservationists came up with. They decided to bring on one flock of pelicans from some other place to Sydney. They decided to mix those pelicans, the new pelicans, with the old ones. Now, the speciality about these new pelicans was that they naturally used to go over the sea and then catch their fishes. Seeing this, old pelicans were inspired, and soon they also joined these new pelicans. And hence, a major catastrophe was avoided. The pelicans continued to live in Sydney, and that is a big thing for the wildlife lovers. Now, the most important thing I think we can deduct from this story is that to be a winner in life, you need to surround yourself with winners. The old pelicans were surrounded with new pelicans, and that is how they learned how to win. Well, I personally believe that I am someone who took a lot of time to decipher this message. I was a person who clung on to relationships for too long. And make no mistake about it, these people were brilliant people. People I really like, people I really adore. But in the back of my mind, I always knew that these were not the people who were striving to be incredibly successful. Ladies and gentlemen, today I ask you this question. Do you want to be a winner in life? Well, if the answer is yes, then start surrounding yourself with winners. It doesn't matter how hardworking you are. It doesn't matter how talented you are, how much hard work you put in, where you were born, where you were raised up. In the long run, what matters is the company you are keeping. That is what decides where you really head towards. And that is one thing that I follow religiously. And because of that, I surround myself with people like Shrey, who has won various contests at different levels. I surround myself with people like Ashish, who delivers modules at various levels to a global audience. I surround myself with Toastmasters, because whoever comes here has the will and the passion to do something creative, to do something amazing. And while I'm giving you this advice of starting to surround yourself with new people, there's also a reason for you to push out old people out of your life. And well, the only assurance that I can give you is that don't be afraid to push out these people from your life. In fact, don't be afraid to push anything out of life, as long as it means that you're surrounding yourself with good things, with good stuff. Instead of becoming the average of average people, strive to become the average of the best. And remember, to be a winner, you need to surround yourself with winners. Over to you, winners.